Welcome back everyone, welcome to my lovely channel, good to talk to you once again. I hope you have all a fantastic weekend and I hope you have enjoy yourself. Summertime is here, there's a lot of stuff going on, and for me, I promise you a replay. Unfortunately guys, I could not play enough with battles in my brand new ÄGIR so I can show you, but I play enough so I have my own experience with her. Some of you guys think that she's a trash, some of you think that she's amazing. Personally, I believe she's definitely a decent, and I do not regret that I purchased her. Honestly, the thing is, and this is kind of a biggest difference, she's not Alaska, she's not quite a German Alaska, but she's not bad either. I believe guys, without saying too much, that she has a little bit more of a HP pool and that it's nice, but also some more weakness. In all my battles with Alaska, I barely never receive some citadels. With this thing, that's the first, my own first battle, I received some citadels, even exactly bow one. So if you say bow one versus, I'm not talking about Musashi, I'm not talking about the let's say Yamato, I'm talking about regular ships like Iowa, like Georgia, they will citadel the crap out of you even if you stay bow one. So you don't quite have the armor of Moskva, you don't have quite the heart to hit that citadel as Alaska. You are more like vulnerable for US or any big guns. I'm talking about battleships guns. So you, no matter what you do, you still have a cruiser armor, not a battleship armor. Your secondary, it's nothing to homer about, it's only 5 kilometers. On the other hand, you don't have either radar, you don't have the tools like the Alaska, and I would like to say probably I didn't even face any aircraft carrier, but I would like to say that the A8's definitely decent. I don't put her better than Alaska, I put her pretty damn close to Alaska, so should I say, very strong. Something else, and I also feel that this HE penetration, that's the biggest difference between this ÄGIR and Alaska, she has a 72 millimeters of HE pen, which you pen everything and everyone, besides if you're doing right aiming and stuff like that. On the other hand, I would like to say that I do have felt, this is my personal opinion, that you have a pretty decent good chance to put your enemy on fire. If you are an HE spammer, it's no problem whatsoever. However, I still believe this ship, you need to learn when to use the HE and when to use the AP, and that's the best thing about this ship. And something else, if you're a battleship, you want to YOLO it and come closer within 6 kilometers, you're doing something terrible wrong, because unlike the Alaska, it does have pretty decent good torpedo, and torpedo angle are pretty alright-ish, not the best, but pretty hard hittings. You might actually kill the battleship with torps if you land all four of them. Something else also is that maybe from close range this thing has a turtleback armor, it won't be so darn easy to citadel her, and together with those huge damn close to battleship guns, they might actually citadel the crap out of you even if you are a darn battleship. Yes, the Yamato, yes, the Musashi is say, oh, there's an ÄGIR, nyam nyam nyam, farm it and kill it. Yeah, it can happen. It can definitely happen. On the other hand, in this replay, you're gonna definitely see huge damn salvo, 35,000 damage salvo versus battleship can only be done by those super cruisers like the Alaska and ÄGIR. ÄGIRs, I believe that in some ways, even though the dispersion could be all over the place, it's more, shall I say, not as reliable, yes, that's the right word, as the Alaska's. it's easier to aim because it has flatter arc than Alaska's. Alaska, you have to learn where to aim because the shells takes time to reach their target, but the shells are extremely tight in Alaska, and that's her strength. And ÄGIR could be all over the place, and sometimes definitely on the spot, but sometimes not as close as the Alaska's. That's the biggest difference, guys. They are both hard hitting, so if you're a cruiser and showing you a broadside, both Alaska and ÄGIR will kill you and will citadel the crap out of you, and you will die in just 2 or 3 salvo. The reload and the DPM on both those two super cruiser are exactly the same, 17.5 seconds with this reload module. And even though, you know, 19.0 and 18.5, that's the range of both those ships without the range module, I still have this feeling that the ÄGIR moves a little bit better in the water, but my build with my Alaska, it's no consumer but rudder, double rudder, which basically means that I'm as big as a house size wise as Alaska, but I turn on the dime. But I pay with way worse concealment, which I don't know if it's a good or a bad thing. ÄGIR with this build, with the concealment build, it's much more stealthier than my build in Alaska. On the other hand, my Alaska has way better turning radius than this ship. But I overall, if you put her apple versus apple, I still believe the ÄGIR moves a little bit better. Rather, and how nimble, how agile this ship is. Overall, guys, I believe that she's not a bad ship. Matter of fact, I'll put her top 3 best cruiser in this game, together with Alaska, ÄGIR, and above all, the number 1 spot, it's this new tier 10 bad boy, the new oncoming tier 10 super Pavlov's guns are from hell. It's literally close to Stalingrad's guns and will citadel the crap of every single ship in the entire game. However, if you're a cruiser, this is what happened. 4 overpen and only 2 pen, of which 1 citadel, and cost 15,000. And what do you think is gonna happen next? I was seriously Buffalo player. Oh man, for love of God, you will die, and this is just 2 salvo and your history. Okay, he did survive, but he took down one of the rear guns. No, definitely this is the last salvo the Buffalo will survive, that's for damn sure. There's the citadel, and then brrm. They have pretty good accurate guns and very hard hitting. I have no idea what's the AP penetration, but I have this feeling they are pretty damn good. Remember, the biggest strength about this ship, it's also HP pool, 62,000. You have Amagi's HP pool, for crying out loud, and Amagi has a very healthy tier 8 battleship, and you do have very close to battleships at tier 8 HP pool. And you have more HP pool than the Odin, and you have the same guns. Of course, better armor for Odin, and way better secondary. You don't have any crazy nothing about the second. Now, very unfortunately, salvo there. Over here is a lot of stuff going on, guys. I have no idea how to explain it, but there's a friendly destroyer nearby, and there's at least 3 enemy ships, of which Dmitry Donskoy, Georgia, and Musashi. And I have no idea how the heck this awesome captain pulled it off. He's from NA server, and his name is rename user 1. I have no idea how he pulled this one. For me, it's still a mystery. And there's the HE spammer Dmitry Donskoy. He returned fire with AP 6900, not bad. Only 1 overpen and 2 pen. That was only three hits. Wait, close to 7,000 damage. However, he hit 8,600, and that it's not a good trade. Also, by the way, also I feel that even though you eat damage, the torpedo belt protection versus Alaska, it's huge. I'm talking about 3 times better or close to that your torpedo belt protection versus Alaska's. You have pretty darn strong torpedo belt protection, and the AP, it's pretty fantastic. 4 pen and 1 ricochet. Well, it was kind of important that I want to show you something, guys. Let's see what's going on over here. And then, yep, that was 25,000 damage, 3 citadel. At close range, guys, those AP perform are crazy strong. Over here, it's 2 torps for close to 20,000 damage. He has a repair party on cooldown. 39,000 for citadel to that Musashi, guys. It was definitely showing how strong this ship is. The friendly torpedo are coming. Oh man, he's gonna go die over here. Absolutely ridiculous. And those torpedo myths, the Yugomos or the, yeah, maybe it was the Östergötland. He missed all the torpedo, but ÄGIR killed the Musashi. And I believe, even though he has very low HP, he nuked that Musashi from full HP to zero. This combination with a lot of citadel, I don't know, was 4 or 5 citadel and some torpedo hits. Yeah, and some secondary and some huge damn guns. Of course, it was a little bit, shall I say, the enemy battleship did not pay attention that supercruiser, and this could definitely also happen for, in Alaska. If a battleship like Musashi is showing you your side to, let's say, Alaska or ÄGIR, it will pay for it. It will pay dearly. And that was definitely showing you how good of a potential. It was close to 40 freaking thousand damage. One salvo. So it's definitely show you, sure, you can nuke this ship, but this ship has the battleship's guns and will reload every 17.5 seconds, same reload as Alaska, and it will hurt you real darn bad. If the guns will not kill you, the secondary and especially the torpedo will do the rest. So that's the reason, in my honestly opinion, this ship is even stronger at close range than Alaska. But the mother of all cruiser is still Petropavlovsk. I still believe it's still work in progress, and we don't know exactly how it is, but it's literally, in my honestly opinion, another Silver Tech 3, you know, Stalingrad. I do like the ÄGIR tanks, how it moves. It moves way, way better than most of the Germans, and especially the Soviet cruisers, which they are kind of a slug. Remember, guys, that big, huge, damn cruiser, they have very hard to disengage, and especially if a battleship like Kreml and Conquerors, or, you know, some other tier 10 like Yamatos, if they aim very good, they will eat citadels left and right. And I have been damaged big time, even from Iwas guns. So what I'm trying to say, you have to pay a little bit of attention to your rudder and your angle versus some battleship, because it's not impossible to receive a lot of damage. Something else kind of forgot, for just a minute or so, this captain had 2,000 something HP pool, and now suddenly, just like that, has 23. I have this feeling that this ship, especially with some captains, and especially with some, yeah, you heard me right, some badass captain with 175,000 coals, it does perform better, and you have some way even better heal than Alaska. Yes, you heard me right. This is way what I feel, because how the heck do you explain from close to 2,000 HP pool to 23,000 just like that? So yeah, and even if you was pay attention to this replay at the very first hill, you have a very huge large green HP regenerated. That's also something else, and I feel that even though this was just pure tier 9 matchmaking, I've definitely shown you that when you're facing tier 8s and tiers, especially tier 7s, you just laugh at them, you just nuke them for days. It does not matter if that enemy ship is a battleship, cruiser, or what the heck it is, you know what I mean. And yeah, I believe this matchmaking is kind of a weird, and I do not recommend any tier 7 premium ships whatsoever. And the reason also showing you this is 1 million million credits game, you will earn credits left and right, and free experience and base experience, commander's experience like nothing else before. Crazy a lot of experience, crazy a lot of free experience, because she's after all a tier 9 super or premium cruiser, and you know, with together with all those new types of flags, you can earn credits and experience buttloads. But remember, this is the way you have to play. You have to play behind your battleship now, not ahead. And a little bit lucky now, he's not targeting, you know what I mean, kind of weird. 910, that was 3 ricochet and 1 overpen, and there's an enemy ÄGIR. It's definitely showing you, if you have some crazy good or perfect angle, this ship is in some way even stronger than Alaska. Once again, guys, this is my personal opinion. There's a lot of ricochet going on left and right, and you need to have the perfect angle versus big caliber guns, and you know, like Georgia can definitely harm you. But it was actually a bounce if you pay attention. Let's see if we can return that favor. 5100 was only 2 pen. But on the other hand, this Georgia overextended, because you know, remember guys, she does have the hydro and torpedo. Oh, there's another ÄGIR. There's 2 ÄGIR and Georgia. Oh crap, 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 crap. Oh, he hit a lot of damage, this captain. Let's see what's going on, if he can do a double kill or something. Oh, Kraken is unleashed. All right, secondary open up is going for the ram, and that's the double strike kill, 1 pen and 6 kills, 291,000 damage, absolutely ridiculous. 4 torpedo hits, 2 flooding, a confederate high caliber and Kraken and all that. So definitely showing you guys that the super cruiser are the way to go. I would like to say that in the next meta, yeah, you will see a lot of battleship, because let's face it, the battleship are made to do one thing, and that is kill other battleship and other cruisers, and especially the cruiser are the one you are focusing first. On the other hand, the super cruiser like Alaska and the ÄGIR will fight back and will hurt you like nothing else before. They do have crazy strong AP performance, and you will make a lot of credits, you will make a lot of you know, experience, and you level up that captain like there's no one's business. So guys, overall, you put yourself in my shoes, and I would like to say that if you have enough with experience, I believe it's not a bad pick, but not the best pick, but not definitely not a bad pick. So yeah, I do not regret that I purchased my ÄGIR. I believe she's a lot of fun, and she has potential in right hands to be very strong ship. Guys, thanks guys for watching, and always captains, fair seas, and goodbye.